Hello guys, and welcome back to another Minecraft video. And today, let me just put all this stuff away. So today I'm going to tell you something before the video starts. So I have been gone for a week because I've been going somewhere with my friend. So I couldn't do any videos, sadly, but I am back now. Better than ever. So now, let's get into writing the video. Today I'm going to be doing a new series, and this time I'll do it like constantly. I know I keep doing a new series and no one does, but the reason why I don't really continue it, because no one likes the video. I usually go into between likes, and I only get like 3 likes a day. It's probably because any of my subscribers aren't active, but if you really, 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 really want the series to go on, tell me down in the comments below. I'll do it in prison series, but I couldn't upload Friday, so, because, you know, I was out somewhere, so, yeah, I couldn't do a prison series. Next Friday, I will do a prison series. So, yes, I'll be doing prison series every Friday from now on. On factions, I'm not sure yet. We didn't get 5 likes on that yet. Alright, so this series is called the Super Redstone Showcase Sunday. And the showcase you're going to show today is this little thing right here. This is, I tried to build another one over here myself, but it didn't work. but this is from a YouTuber named Peter Jang. I'll just put some, I can't really say about, his channel's down in the description. He made a 2x2 flush, before I say it, this is a 6x6 flush and seamless piston door. So as you can see, if you don't know what flush means, is when it closes, it is really flush to the wall. So if it's all the same blocks, you wouldn't even notice there was a door right here. And seamless is, of course, is when all the when there's no freaking visible redstone, as of pistons, repeaters, anything invisible. It can also be, so see, there's no kind of redstone, you don't see anything. So I am going to close this, but first of all, I should have done this earlier, I just forgot. We're going to it is terrific. Because it'd be more easier to see it if I run an input up on the top here, so way more easier to see. Alright, so then we're over there. Yeah, I just need to do this real quick. I don't like to do editing right now. Still learning, okay? Look, I'm a slow learner sometimes when I go to complex code stuff and other things. Oh, wait. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I don't like to go 15, but just in case, I like to have a repeater here. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. So there we go. We got our little thing here. I'm going to show you this now. See the closing. As you can see, it's completely flush. You don't even, if you just looked at this, you wouldn't even know there was a door right here. It looks like just a random wall. But now we can see the opening, which is really, really unique in my opinion. So, by the way, this is, I tried on 1.9. I'm not sure if it actually works on 1.9. But before I can even try it, my computer crashed. It's not going to test it on 1.9. But 1.8 does work with this. It does. So now we'll stop talking. See the opening. You know, the opening's really unique. Okay. So there you have it. That's the flesh. So I'm going to try to explain as best as I can. Super Wrestling Studies is going to be a long video of explaining this thing. Now, I kind of looked into most of it at least, so some parts I probably got to think a bit to actually explain. Because remember, this is like around 3,000 blocks in volume, so it's just going to be really, really tough to explain. I can't explain in here because this is just broken. I tried to build it, but it broke. Like, as you can see here, it's like these pistons didn't extend for some reason. I don't know. But yes. So now if I go to game mode 3. Game mode 3 is much more easier to explain. Because, you know, I can go for blocks. I can show where the pistons are. I can show all the redstone more easily. Yeah, so it was a good explanation. So the pink circuit is the input circuit. So basically when you power this will go into a brown circuit. And then when you turn off this torch, nothing will happen because of, obviously, this is a dropper. It doesn't power when this turns off, so. Yes, so none of the purple circuits or the rest of this input circuit gets fired. But we're going to focus on this little section right here, which is the brown circuit. The brown circuit is the closing of the tire door. So, I can show you the layout, actually. Down here is a quint. This is a quint. So this is this right here. Yeah, quint. A quintuple extender. Facing up. And then right here is the storage, which has a quad piston extender, which is not really, it just pushes up, and then when it opens, it'll just, this piston will push down, pushing all the pistons back down. But yes, see, this is what I mean, this is like really hard to explain. But you see these inputs right here, these inputs, there's one input right here, another input up here, another input up here. You see these inputs? Yeah. And then this input here. This is what matters. And also some of these inputs. I think this input and then this input. It's mostly this input that fires. But, yes. Yeah, so we do want to power this line first. So what happens is when this fires, what's gonna happen is after 5 ticks, this line is gonna start to power. So this quad extender, I think 1, 2, 3, 4, yep, it's the first piston's gonna push up like power, and then at the right time this pushes up, as you can see, there's an airspace there. Before the piston pushed up, this is only the, like, 2 ticks, right? Yeah, no, 3 ticks. So after 3 ticks, this is 5 ticks, this is gonna start a clock. So this is going to fire this, going up here. So wait, that's 5 ticks then, but that doesn't matter, it still works. And then it goes up these slabs, powers this repeater, and it'll power this. So this will power, firing this into here, and then at the same amount of time, this is going to power this line. So that means it's going to power again, which the box will be right here, and the clock will still be running. So this clock right here, as you're looking at, is going to fire again, and then after 1, 2, 3, and 4, yeah. Yeah, after 4 ticks, this line of powers. So the second rows of pistons will be up into where the furnace is next to. And it's gonna power it again, and you get the drill. So it'll fire into there, and then after, when we get down there, this will have a 4-tick repeater, after up here, and then after four more ticks, this is gonna go up here and fire it again. So this is gonna fire a third time, and then after four more ticks, which is this repeater, this will go into this line and power it again. And this clock is going to power this four times, because there's four, this, well, six times actually, because there's six, no, five times. This is gonna power this storage fire thing. It's gonna fire five times because there's five sets of blocks, and then the sixth block is this floor right here. So that's basically the storage. Now this piston, after eight ticks, it's going to stop. It's going to stop the clock, because so that means it'll finish the closing. You won't hear any piston noises. And now, how do they send up into the door? So, probably wondering. Well, if we go back here, after it gets in this input, right? This input will go into this dust, power on monostable, go in these two tick repeaters and fire this. So, yeah, so this will repeatedly go and go. And then down here nothing happens. Except for this down here. So if we go, like, go a dust down here. Wait, no, never mind. That's the power thing. I'm retarded. But yes, so this will power stop it. So yeah, so that means this little thing powers constantly. And then when the last block comes, we need to double extend, I think. No, triple extend. Triple extender. So. Yeah, so. This will fire, pushing it up. This will fire, pushing it up. And then one more will fire, which I can't really. Yeah, right here. This will fire again, so. Up here, so just like that. And then, so what will happen now? Fucking game mode one. So that's how the, as you can see, like that. See how the closing is in. And then, as I told earlier in the circuits, see, this torch is turned off, not powering this dropper. And this when this dropper powers and this dropper powers, it's automatically starts this circuit. So opening circuit. So let's see here. The reason why there's a monostable here, and as you can see, it stopped. When we retract it, all it will do is retract. It won't power this line. So literally nothing will happen during this brown circuit. But if we go back to game mode 3, I'm gonna try my best to explain this entire rest of this door. Oh god. If there's something I am confused about, I'm sorry, but I can't really help you there. Okay, let's start. So when this, when we flick down this lever, or whatever lever you place it, right here maybe, it's just gonna activate, so this won't power because all we'll do is retract, so none of this brown circuit will fire. But down here, when we depower it, this will, power and power this dropper, and since there's a block above, it will power this dropper. So this dropper down below just continues the input circuit, which is the pink. So what happens here? This dropper is going to fire, and since there's already items in this hopper, as you can see, this 24 redstone there. Or items, as you can call it. This is gonna lock it. So this is gonna power, and since this computer is powered, it will lock this hopper into place. It will never go back. Unless, so this is going to, this is what locks, this computer was what locks this. So when this depowers, it's gonna start to go back into this hopper. And when it depowers, this is gonna go back here, and then, by the way, this torch also powers too, so this stays locked, and when it goes back, it's gonna power, it's going to depower again, which then will go back into here. And when it goes into here, this pulse will fire into this torch, leaving it on for long time, but this won't matter because all this does is just powers this dropper. So we're just going back instantly. So this doesn't really matter that much, but this does matter, and it's this little thing that'll power this line, and we'll talk about this later because this is just a input. But this I've been looking into this, and I think this is a pulse lengthener, which is continuing letting the pulse not happen to any of the bottom circuitry until the top gets into its place and does a triple. That's what I think it is for looking for this. I'm not sure, but Peter Jang, if you're watching this, please tell me what this circuit is. But, yeah, so, but I'll try to explain as much as possible. This, dropper will power this, see, this is a dropper, so this is the same circuit we talked about down here. It's just powering this hopper. This thing has more items in it, so this will stay longer inside this hopper than usual. So this will go into here, and I'll power this for a long time, so just take 64 plus 50, and then times that by 2, and that's how many ticks this will stay off. And then after that many ticks, it will turn back on, firing this circuit, I think. I don't know what circuit it fires. Okay. So yeah, then this will turn off. See, this will retract, so nothing will happen. So then there's a torch here, so nothing will happen to this right here. This won't power off. But when it goes back into here, this will power on, firing a monostable. And then this piston will retract, and there's an item in this furnace. When I showed you this, you probably thought, oh, it's probably for unmovable, but it's not. It's for when it retracts, and will power this comparator, and then power this dust, powering this hopper with an unstackable item, so we can have a long enough reach to power that piston. And I'll, and of course, it will power that piston. And then this is just, this part is for later. When we get to the green circuit, this just locks this for now. And then when we, when it turns back on, when we look into this, a purple circuit right here, when we go back into the yellow, this is going to fire. But in the green, this is also going to fire, but do nothing, because this is locked. So, this is just to make sure the pulse doesn't fire during at the wrong pulse, making the door small. That's what I believe. Now, Peter Jang, I may be wrong, okay? Any excellent explanation, I may be wrong, but I've been trying to study this through this door a lot, and I'm trying to, trying to understand how the door works. But if I do get something wrong, I apologize, okay? I don't like, especially if we're trying to explain a door 300,000 blocks. Not 300,000 blocks, 3,000 blocks. Yeah. But yeah, so when I was looking for this, it looks like a pulse lengthener because we don't want anything else to power. So that's my theory at least. But yeah. Now, I guess I can start going through this little thing section right here. All right, so when this powers, which I'm not sure how it powers. Oh, yeah. Let's drop a little fire. And then this will power this dust. And 4 ticks is gonna power. And then 12 ticks, we'll talk about this later, will power even more stuff. Well, this actually is a input, which will actually power this repeater. This fully tracks, nothing will happen, so it doesn't really matter. But this will fire to here, and this is what starts in the blue circuit, which is the triple. So this will fire upwards, so this will fire into this. There's a furnace, so this is a unlimited power source. This will fire into this torch, doing a torch tower, and another torch will fire into this, and there's another torch that'll go up and fire this. And there's also a repeater below this. Oh wait, never mind. Never mind, that's going the opposite direction, it's powering that line. But if you go up here, this will power a lot of things. But before this thing powers, all other stuff powers. And when this fires, this little circuit, which I do not know any what I can call the circuit is, but there's a permanent redstone block right here. Oh, when this puts up, it'll fire this, fire into this torch, go up into this torch, fire into this dust, and into this, and then this will fire this, and this is a permanent furnace with a wooden shovel inside it. So when this is There's a comparator always on here. When this pushes up, this will turn off since this glass is transparent. So this little thing will turn off. And as you can see, these are extended, making the flush happen. So when this turns off, right? So when this turns off because there's a glass block here, it's gonna turn off these pistons. So this will retract and then start this little tape circuit. So now how does this work? So it's like there's an input there, a to this piston, and then input there to this piston, because so and then there's a piston up top, up here, powered by this repeater, and then this repeater is powered by this. So when this retracts, what's going to happen, right? This is going to have to fire first. But so I'll try to explain as much as possible. So when this pulls up, this the glass block here turns off, just like I said earlier. But this redstone block pulses up, deactivating this, making this not locked. And going to this hopper, and they're actually just going back and forth to each other. But this won't happen because there's a monostable here, if I'm correct. So it won't actually give a continuous pulse like usual. So this will fire into this circuit, which we'll go back to later, but this is main one will fire to here. So this is gonna power right, but now we need this to power, but thankfully this little spacer here. This after 2 ticks, this will power. So this will go up here, power this first piston here, second piston here, and then the third piston will be right here. So now we need to power this piston. And when this thing goes up here, this will go up here into a 1 tick, And then this will go into a, yeah, this dust here, so just like this. This will go to a 1 tick pulse right here, because we don't want to power it like this into that dust. We want to power this first. So this will push down, and then there'll be a new block down here. And then this little circuit here, after 3 ticks, is going to power this. And then the whole cycle goes on again. I'm going to try to find that cycle. Oh wait, never mind. I was wrong about this thing. This will continually power doing all this whole thing until eventually this will go to a 4 tick. So eventually, so these 4 tick repeaters, these 3 4 tick repeaters in this 1 3 tick repeater will give it exactly the amount of time to do its thing. And so, oh wait, another 3 tick repeater. So this clock will go on for 2 times 4 times 3, 12. 12 plus 6, so 18 ticks. And then this will fire into here, giving a 1 tick, so that's 19 ticks. So 19 ticks this will go around, and when this fires back down, there's gonna be a block here. So this furnace will this comparator will have an output, and this will fire again right here. So this will do that. And then, since the redstone block is down back to this place, this will lock the item back into this hopper right here. Right here. So that's how this circuit stops. So I can call this science circuit. I can't really call it. It's a tape. It's a type of tape, but I don't really know what to call the tape. But yes, yeah, so hopefully none of that confused you. Please. So now the pistons, so when it's done, these pistons will be at here, and then when it stops, it's going to fire this back into here, and then it's going to start another circuit, which is the blue circuit, and I don't know what to call this one either, because this is another type of tape. I'm gonna try to explain it a bit, I guess. But if you go down all the way down to the bottom here, I see this piston. I need to figure out how this is powered, first of all. Oh, I see. So this torch will power this, not only this dust, it will power this. And then this is going to power. And there's a furnace right here, giving an output. 3 ticks going to here, powering this dropper. And it's not going to go any other these hoppers, but it's going to go into here, power that. It's going to this comparator, and this 2 tick repeater, and then we're going to power this piston to power this dropper, not the dropper below it. So this will power this. And then this is going to go through, it's going to start the tape, so this is going to fire and start the tape. What this is a long, long, long amount of hoppers. So as you can see, yeah, so when this fires, where's the thing? Right here. So this will go into here, and then this will go into here, here. Yeah, this will go into here, all the way around here. Yeah, get the idea. So let's go all the way around back here. And while this is off, this comparator is powering the dust, locking this wind shovel. When this goes around, this is in subtract mode, and as you can see, there's a dust going back into here. This dust, make sure it doesn't butt power this piston right here. So this will go around, right? So when it starts, it's gonna fire this. 1 tick, a repeater which will fire this constantly. So what this does is just fires back, cuts it off, and then it will go around, fire it again, cuts it off. Well, wait. But yeah, this is basically a clock, I think. I can't really explain this. I'm not really too good with the comparators, but I understand most comparators. But basically, what this is just going to keep going. So this clock will fire to here. And the first thing it's going to fire is these pistons right here. So this will fire. Oh, okay, I see now. This is going to cut it off, firing it again into this, so it's going to retract it, because this is going to give a one tick pulse. So it's going to fire, and then it's going to retract it again. And then, since this is a four tick, it doesn't get accept one tick pulses, except for the one. So this is going to power a double extender back here. So after this box has been retracted, this is going to power this double extender, which is going to, wait. Hold on a second, let me recap a bit. Because I'm trying not to get anything wrong so you guys can understand how this door works, because I don't want to be anything wrong. Let me recap a bit. What I mean is this is going to power, but this is going to cut off and power again. But this 4-tick repeater will be already on before that happens. And after the 4-tick repeater will shut off, this is going to power. So this is going to retract, and then it's going to grab these blocks. So this is going to double extend, basically. So these from these inputs right here. So this repeater and the repeater above. And then these 3-tick. It'll be using part of this circuit, but it's going to go up here. It's going to... This stuff will power this, and this 2-tick repeater will power this, doing the final retraction. And then this little thing is going to loop around, going to back here, and it's going to fire again. So it's going to fire, and then the 4-tick does the double extender. It's going to keep going and going and going. And while this is being fired in back and forth 1,000 times, this is going to power 1-tick repeater. This is going to update this piston, firing to here, getting this comparator up to here, and this dropper will be used later. But this is also going to fire from this dropper. And this is going to constantly power this dropper, which is going to go into power to this. And this is going to power constantly back and forth, locking each other. So, yeah, and then this is going to power through here. So this is going to be like where it stops this circuit. So this little thing is going to stop the circuit. But this, so what happens is, to stop this circuit, this is going to, where is that hopper? So confusing. There it is. It's going to go back and forth powering this little thing. Thing right here, so this will power this dropper firing to this. So this is gonna give a lot of delay in one little space. But when this powers, this is going to power this triple, and it's also going to stop this comparator from powering. So when this does this, this is going to cut off the signal right here when this powers. And it's going to, so it's going to cut off, so it's not going to power anymore, stopping the tape. But it's also going to be powering this triple extender, so it's going to start the triple, pushing down all the blocks. Oh, I forgot to do the rest of the blue. So when this tape is going around, this repeater will power this dust, which will power this 2-tick repeater. This dust will go up here and power this. And it's also just going to be a slab here. So this is going to basically power this, so it's gonna push this block, it's gonna go over here, and then, you know, this clock is going, powering double extends, and then this powers, and then another one comes. Yeah, you get the idea when I showed you in the opening. And this will go back into this torch, Let's go back to this dust. This dust here. And this will be a torch, which will power this. So this will basically power pushing this into here. And it's just going to keep going. It's just going to keep going and going and going. Until this little circuit decides to cut off this comparator and stop it from powering anymore. So that means none of the system will stop. Will be done. And also, what also stops it is from this. So this will go all the way. It'll go back into here, locking this. And it'll go back to here, right here. So this will stop. Yeah, you get the idea. All the tape will stop. And then a triple extender activates. So this triple extender will fire into this. Now, you may be thinking, this repeater is firing this piston, that's bad. No, because when this tape is fired, they'll be switched with solid blocks. So what will happen is this three-tick repeater will power, and these will be solid blocks. These will be solid blocks. So these will power this. And then also during that time, these are the updater pistons. They're gonna power these updater pistons, making sure they are actually powered. Sorry if this is so hard to explain. Holy crap! But also this will go up, depowering this torch, but also goes up here. And then so nothing will happen because it's a drop on hopper. Nothing will happen because it's off. And when it turns on again, it's going to fire a drop on hopper, firing this thing again. And also when this goes up here, this will go up here. I'm not sure how this dropper power is actually. Oh, this torch, yeah. So this will power up here. Two tick pulse, this will be solid blocks, so it'll go to here. And there you know, this is a three tick. And then going up here is a two tick. Pulse is a one tick difference, but still works. And down here is a three tick and a three tick, so it'll power through right here. And we use that for timing purposes, so don't worry. So, yes, and then this will go up here, how one tick, a three tick, and so that's basically four ticks right here. This is six ticks. This will power this, and this will power this. So this will fire this two tick, and then after one tick again, it will fire this again, and it will do the triple. So then so that'll be the finish of the triple. It'll be the finish of the triple. Actually, no, might be. There'll be a three tick repeater here, powering this dust right here. I'll power this piston, nothing will be here, so it doesn't really matter. And this four tick will power it again, then finishing the triple. So that's a oh my god. And we're not done yet. We've still got god. Alright, so that's the triple. So then after it's done, this long pulse extender thing right here, we're gonna be going here. So this will go into power for this block. But we also main power is this. So this will power through this into these two tick repeaters. Two tick and four tick. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So six really long tick delayed repeaters. It's giving it enough time to fire all the circuits up there. And when this does, this will power this, firing into this. So this is, I guess, this is going to be like the thing that's going to get ready for the piston tape on the bottom piston tape. But I'm not sure. This is going to power this two tick repeater going up here, two ticks. Powering this dropper, and then this comparator, and it's just going to be, and this is a slab, so it doesn't go down, it only goes up. And this is going to power this line, and so this is basically going to grab these pistons. But this is going to also go up here, up here, up here, up here, up here, to all these four deck repeaters, so fire into this. This will go into here, powering this furnace to nothing, so it's just a furnace. This will go down here into a four-tick repeater, down this torch, and this torch is going up here, two-tick repeater, stands already here. So it's going to be a one-tick repeater, powering this dust, and then we'll start the tape. Up here. And then this four-tick repeater, so when we power this, this also powers this, powering that line. And that's gonna, basically there'll be a block here, because all the pistons gonna push it down, and so these pistons should be pushed down then. So I need to refix my thing then, so that means this comparator is going to power when we two blocks down. So they'll be basically pushed up. So they will be pushed up into back into position. But at the same time, this will power and it'll power up the thing. And that's what this little circuit does right here. Right here. But this is also going to power down, power this two tick. Then this is going to power this dust into a monostable, giving a one tick pulse. This is going to give a one tick pulse to this little circuit here, and that's going to push another section, the pushing up the block for the tape. So that little thing right there, and then this down here, when this powers, this is going to power this, powering this. So it's going to be, that's going to be another part of the tape. So I think that's all. Oh god. Yeah, a lot of confusing stuff. So then the pistons, so then we're going to get to the tape now, because that's the next circuit that we'll be activating, obviously. And it's, there it is. So this is activation of the tape. So what happens here is this will power a four tick, depower four tick repeater, which will retract this, power this four tick repeater, powering this piston, pushing this over into here, powering this piston. There's a pertinent torch here, and don't worry, there's a block above it, because all there is a repeater, so it's fine. But this repeater is going to power this thing when it pushes up into here. This redstone is going to power this into this comparator, powering this down. And by the way, this little thing right here is also for budding too, if you didn't know. So this, when this triple goes down here, this is also for budding, because the pistons will be down here, and then up here we'll be able to power, so that's also another thing I forgot to mention. But yeah, let's go back to the bottom tape circuit. But this dust will depower this, which will also depower this. This is what item is it's in. There's some dust, and this is going to depower this piston, retracting this. Retracting this, so nothing will happen. But there's 29 items. This will go into here, so, and then go, so this will go back and forth. So this is going to fire again. But this is a hopper clock right here, so this will go back into here. And this stuff is powering, this hopper is going to go back here. So the 29 times 2, and that's how long this table will be going for. And this is going to go into this comparator. And after it's done, it's going to go to the comparator and stop the tape by powering this again. This dust right here. So yeah, I'll stop it. And then right here, this is the pulses that go into here. So this is a basic thing. So this will power this first. So it's going to. So this is going to power and then retract quickly. And then 2 ticks later, powers this, pushes over there. And then there's the torch above here powering this dust. So this block goes here. It's gonna power for this block, which above this block is a piston. So this is gonna push over here. And 3 ticks later, it's gonna power this block into this dust, powering this block, which above it would be a piston. So gonna push over there. And then this clock is gonna be a clock, so it's gonna keep running. So at the perfect time when it gets here, a clock's gonna fire again, pulling, push. And then the rest of the torch, it goes all around, 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 and around again. And then this tick will stop it. And then also, when the redstone block gets here, it's going to use the quince to finish off this tape. So this is going, this whole yellow circuit is going to finish off the tape. So this is extended. When this retracts, this is not going to do anything because this is going to depower, not going to do anything because, of course, it's a dropper. And this is going to power this, making sure it stays up. And then this, because this is going to give, this over here is going to give 1 tick pulses. So when it fires, it has to stay up. So this repeater will power this, and this dust will power this 3 tick repeater, making sure it stays up like that. And then when it retracts back down, these two just retract. So this will retract first, and then this will retract. So it's like a double extender, like almost finishing its double extension basically. And this will fire into here, firing into this comparator, firing into this dust, and firing into this little section right here. But also, it's going to fire into this here. And it's going to fire to this block, into this repeater, firing to here, going to here, 4 ticks, down here. It's going to power a 2 tick repeater. So this is going to grab this block, pull it down. Down, and this is going to go keep continuing to go further down. Further down here, so this is going to power a lot of stuff here. This is going to power here, all the way down here, power this dust, and then this torch. This torch will depower this, power this, power this line, and then depower this, pulling it down. But then it's gonna repower, it's going to fire this little circuit here. And thanks to this mono stable, this block will pull down. So yeah, and this little thing here will go into here, pulse this, and fire this. So this will be fired twice because there's another circuit down here. So after 4 ticks, this will fire again, and this is going to go in this torch, power this input there. And then if you go down here, there's a slab there, nothing power that piston. And then there's gonna be a 2 tick repeater. So as to say, a 4 tick repeater, power that, yeah, just like I showed you, this will power again. And then this will actually depower this torch, doing this little thing again too. But there'll be no piston up there because it's all been retracted. But so yes, and then this will grab it. Which I'm not sure how. Oh, yeah. This 4 tick repeater caused by oh yeah, this dust here. This also powers 3 tick repeater powering this. Powers this and powers this little input here. I forgot the input. But when this powers here, this is going to go this is when it's going to fire the storage here. So this is going to fire this piston with the sand on top. Permanent comparator source here, which will power this. So this will grab the block. So this is going to happen every time the pulse. So this is going to happen every time the quad finishes. So this is going to fire to here. And then 4-6 after is going to fire again. It's going to fire again. And by the way, not to mention how, you're probably asking, how does these pistons right here power? When the piston tape fires, it's going to go around. So nothing will happen right now, but this will just retract, extend, retract. Because 4-tick is last long, so it just is going to extend and retract for no reason. But it's going to extend, though. You think it's... Wait, sorry, let me rephrase that. You think it's going to just extend and retract for no reason. But the reason why we extend and retract because... While this is being pulled down, this needs to have a block here. So repeaters power it. So when there's pistons above the block, it will be the piston will be powered. So that's what that's for. This will power it to here again. So this will do the same thing, power this line. Put the block there. So when this powers, it will power the pistons above. So that's what that's used for. So yeah, that will power again. So then there's nothing else, right? Nope, there's still some pulses down here. So this will go into here. This dust, nothing will power for this block, but it'll power through here. 2-tick, 2-tick into a block right here. And the 2-tick into a monostable, giving a 1-tick pulse. And then giving this little pulse, a lot of pulses here. So this is going to be a pulse. 1, 2, 3, giving this pulse down here, and then giving a pulse down over here and over here. So this pulse will go into here, powering this, and then this is going to go around here, going through here, powering this, and then it's going to power this little circuit I talked about earlier, if you remember. It's going to power for this block, and power this piston. Power this line. So this is going to fire again. So this little thing is going to fire again. So this, that's what, so, because this is going to be fired after the yellow circuit's been done. So this is going to go into here, fire this, and fire this, and then this is going to here, firing this line. And then it will start the tape again because of this little circuit right down here. And now I'll power this green circuit again, getting ready for the final retraction again, and of course firing the tape again. Now before, and also at the same exact time where the tape fires again, we have a little bit of pulses going on here. So this is, like I talked about this little torch here, right? Right? So, yeah. Let me just find, hold on, I need to find the input for this, from this. Oh, all right. So green, I think it's the refiring for the top. So this is gonna refire this, power for this 4-tick repeater, power for this, nothing will happen, just powers this dust, powers for a 4-tick, but also down here a 3-tick. So 3-ticks will go into here, power for this, power for this, and it's going to power this line, powering a making sure it fires again. And yeah, this is just an extra input right here from this circuit. So, but up here, this will fire into a two-tick repeater, firing into another two-tick repeater, firing this, will fire this. And yeah, so we'll just fire it. But is that like I missed? Not sure. What did I miss? Did I miss something? Oh, I already talked about this. I'm so dumb. Where the frick is the output to get up to this little thing here? How does this fire again? Oh, yeah, this is going to fire again. Yeah, this little circuit here is going to fire again up into this triple circuit. So it's going to fire the triple again. And then at the same time, after it's done, it's going to fire this. So this is going to go again. And then this is going to... And then this is the yellow circuit fires again. And then... And then, yeah, of course, and then the thing fires again, right? So then, now this time when the tape goes around, it's going to power these pistons for a reason this time. So it's actually going to push the blocks down. In fact, in the storage. So, yes. And by the way, when this happens 6 more times... So it's gonna stop. It's just going to stop. How is it gonna go to stop? Well, a reason. Block storage is full. The storage is going to be full. So when this circuit right here from the green, it's going to power. It's going to do nothing. It's going to do nothing. So that means it will end all the circuits and everything. And that's how the door is working. That's how the door works. If I'm right. So, explaining all of this. If I just flip this. Thank you. yeah, just like I forgot to say, I forgot to explain one more thing. The tape is going to fire Organa at some point due to the storage not being filled. So this is going to fire this green orange circuit, which will fire cycling around the thing I told you again. It's going to put the blocks back into place. But before that happens, it's the blue's going to fire first due to block storage filling. So now it's, and then after that, this thing fires. And I can't really find the pulses. Now, so that's all the explanation I can do for you guys. So, I'm going to go back to game mode 1. So, I'm sorry. So, yes, that's all the explanation I can give you. Now, Pyrjang, you know, if you guys don't know, Pyrjang is if I said before, Pyrjang is the creator of this door. Pyrjang, if I miss anything, please point them out. Now, I'll probably miss a lot of things in the store, so, because, you know, it's 3,000 blocks, and it's also really complicated, redstone mechanics, and all of that, so, please tell me if I miss any explanation. I probably missed a lot, so, but anyways, guys, thank you guys for watching, hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye. Hope you like the store and how it works, and see you guys next time.